This stream is sponsored by Microsoft Azure. We're going to be doing a series where we make a game using some features from PlayFab. And these features will allow us to have users sign up, log into the game, play it on different devices, make a high score in the leaderboard, and save and load data on different platforms. So it's a really useful tool. I think it's really, for what you're doing, it's so easy to use. I'm going to be explaining how to do sign up and login today. And it can be used for all different types of games. We're going to be making a sort of Sims slash Tamagotchi style game. So we have little people that hatch out of an egg, like regular humans do, obviously. And they're going to live in a little box, which is going to be either on our phone or on our computer. You can move them around and they can interact with things that you can get for them and put in their environment, and they can go up to it and react. They're going to have different little personalities. It's going to be super cute. And we've decided to call it Pocket People. It's looking pretty bare bones right now. This is Unity, if you guys are not familiar with it. We have the very basic UI. We have our sign up. I haven't even labeled them yet, but we'll show you how to do the bare basic stuff, and then we'll make it look nice. And you guys will be able to try it and log in and move around a character. It's not very interesting yet, but it will slowly build it out, flesh it out, both with the PlayFab stuff and the actual gameplay stuff. Let's start coding it out. As you guys can see, let me show you my hierarchy here. We have a canvas, and on our canvas we're gonna need, for this part specifically, a start panel section, which has the sign up and login. There are two different tabs. So when this is active, it has the sign up information. When login is active, it has the login information. And then when our start panel is active, we see this. And when it's not, we see just start game. So again, it's very, very basic. I just want to show you guys how to put it together, and then we'll make it look fancy. Make a nice big start game button here. We're going to say begin. Okay. So this is what we're starting with, okay? Now, before we continue, actually, there's another thing I want to share with you. Before we start using PlayFab, we do need to install PlayFab in Unity. So here's some info on PlayFab. This is a link to help you get a quick start with it. And if you go here, from this page, you can go to SDKs, Game Engines, Unity 3D. If you click on Unity 3D here, gives you a little overview, and you have some downloads. There's the quick download link, for the Unity Editor extensions and the PlayFab SDK. If you get both of these, you'll be set. Once you have those, you'll also need a PlayFab account. So you can go to playfab.com, or you can click the link here in chat. You can sign up. Once you're signed up, we're gonna log in. I'm already logged in, it looks like. And it shows you your studios. I have a bunch of different test ones with different interesting names on them. And we made a little box of creatures here. In that, you want to get your ID, okay? You want to get this ID here. That's right here on your dashboard of your developer account. Once you've created a studio, it automatically creates a game, and on that game is the ID number. And you want to connect your game from PlayFab to Unity. So you can click on PlayFab, make PlayFab shared settings, and you're going to put your ID here. That's not the right thing. You're going to copy the ID from your PlayFab dashboard, and then you're going to put in your developer's secret key, which you can get by going to, I'm going to tell you and not show you. This is a very important secret, okay? You can't share secrets, otherwise it's not a secret anymore. Go to your game that you're using, click on it. Title setting, so that will bring us here. Then over here you can see secret keys, okay? You can see this link here, secret keys. Click it when no one's looking, so it stays a secret, and it's a long key. You're gonna copy it, you're gonna hide it from people, and then you're gonna paste it into this thing here. Because it's a secret key, I'm not gonna show you. And now it should link up. There we go. So that should get you set up, connected to your, and it should get your Unity game connected with your PlayFab account. Once that's good to go, we are going to start doing the code. So over here, I made just a separate game object, an empty one, and I put the PlayFab control script on it. Let's open the PlayFab controls here. If you see me looking at the screen, I did write it out and test it before, but I'm going to go through it with you together as we type it out again. There's a few things that we're going to cover, both the Unity stuff and the PlayFab stuff. So let's go ahead and start by serializing some game objects so that we can see them in the inspector. And I'm realizing it's kind of tricky to see, so let's make a dark background for us here. Game object. We're going to need our sign up tab, our login tab, our start panel, and our HUD, which is just our start game button. So this is going to be what we show up when we've successfully signed up or logged in. And I think that's all we need for now. Then we need public text. And since we're using text, we're going to need to make sure that we have our namespace for unityengine.ui. And we're going to need our two PlayFab namespaces. One is using PlayFab and one is using PlayFab.clientModels. Once these are in, we can continue using PlayFab stuff and Unity's UI stuff. And our text we're going to need is our username. We're going to need our user email, our user password, and then I did a separate one. So these are our signup fields, and then we're going to need text for our login fields. So user email for login and our user password for login. Sign up and error log in. And now we need one more thing, which is a string for the encrypted password that we're going to do. Encrypted password. So the first part is going to be the Unity part where we can switch between the sign up or login. And we're just going to be as simple as public void sign up tab. And then we're going to do like public void login tab. So our sign up tab, we're going to set to true, set active. And for our login tab, and when we click sign up, it will close the login. So login tab set active false. And then we're gonna just do the opposite here. So we're gonna set the, when we open the login tab, sign up is false, login's true. No more errors now. Okay, we're good. Now we have all of our items here in the inspector. So let's put our sign up tab here, our login tab here, our start panel, our HUD, and then we're gonna want the text that we have. So these are all text fields. And one thing we can also do is tell it what type of text field it is. So if you click on the text fields game object, there is a place that asks or says content type. This is username, we're gonna say alphanumeric. And for the email input, we're gonna say email address. For password input, we're gonna say password. And this will make sure that it's start out basically. I'm gonna do those as well while we're here for the login also. Okay, but what we want is the text part of these. So we put the text in username input, we put into username. Email input, we put into email. Password, we put into password. Same deal with our login. Text for the email, text for the password. And then we have two text fields. One is in our signup tab. That's for any errors that come up. So error signup, and one text here for, so it's not a text field. It's just a text game object. And that's here, login. Now they're all linked together. The only thing we've coded so far is switching between tabs. So I'll show you that. It's pretty straightforward. Here I put in have an account, login. We could make this look nicer, but it gets the idea across. We have our little login information, create an account, takes us here, sign up, have an account, takes us back to login. So far, so good. The next thing we're gonna do is we are going to make a encryption function. So it's going to output a string and we're gonna call it encrypt. It's going to take a string, we'll call it just pass. And we're going to use this line here. System Security Cryptography, MD5. This is an MD5 encryption tool. You can look them up. They're available to use. We'll call it X equals new System Security Cryptography, MD5 crypto service provider. And then we're gonna say bytes, BS equals system.txt encoding, UTF-8, get bytes pass is exactly what we want. BS equals x dot compute hash and system dot text dot string builder. Yeah, that's what we want right there. For each byte b in BS, s dot append b to string x2. And then we'll return s to string. Now that we have that done, we can start doing our register. So we just go public void sign up var register request equals new register PlayFab user request we have here. And we're going to put email equals our email up here, user email equals. So here we do encrypt and then we put user password. We want emails, username, email.text. And then we have username equals username.text playfab client API dot register playfab user register request register success register failure. And we're going to need to make both of these. So let's do that now. Public void register success and public void register error of let's see, register error. It's that time of day when I lose my voice. Excuse me. Okay, we got it back. Register PlayFab user results. Okay, and we're going to make sure any errors go away. Okay, so error sign up dot text equals no text. Our start panel holds the login information, so we're going to set it to false since we are now logged in. Login dot text is set to error generate error report. This is for login. We need to send this to a sign up. And we're going to do another one for login error. And here we'll say error login. Also, I'm just thinking when we switch between login and sign up, let's set our errors to be empty so that we don't still see the login error each time we once we switch back and forth. And if we are successful, we'll clear out any errors that show up. And our last thing that we need is our login with its login success and failure. So if we log in with success, we're gonna want public void login success. There it is. And what we can do is start game from there, just like we do with our sign up success. Same stuff here. We'll put in our login success. And then we'll need our PlayFab function here to tell it to check it, basically. So this one goes like this. Login var request equals new login with email address request user email login.txt equals the encrypted password, but it's not user password login this time. There we go. Then we want PlayFab client API dot login with email address request comma login. Then we have the login success. May as well copy paste so there's no errors. Comma. Okay, this should be everything we need to get going. Here we go. Login button. PlayFab controls login. And on our sign up button over here, sign up button. PlayFab controls. Sign up. I think that's everything we need to link. Let's check our controls. Looks good. Let's give it a try. Okay, to test it, what we're gonna do. Here is what it looks like when you log into PlayFab in your browser. This is a list of our player so far. This is my user that I made yesterday. We're going to sign up here. Username, Lana. Email will be lana@lana.com. And password is a secret word. And then we click sign up. And it was successful. So it switched to begin. And if we click begin, our game starts. Pocket people, we forgot to turn off the title. We have our name randomizer. And it takes us to the next scene. Plays the rest of the game as we tell it to. Now, we can double check that this worked by going over here, refreshing. If it doesn't show up, you can click search. It may take a minute. There it is. There's our second user right here, logged in from Canada. And we have our user number, our username. Info is on it if you click on it. And now we can log in with it. So if we go have an account, log in, and I type in my email and the password I set, log in. Now we're logged in, we can begin again. And PlayFab will take care of some of the errors, but you're probably gonna want to take care of a chunk of them on your own. For example, if it's empty and you click sign up, you know, we have this thing here like client slash register PlayFab user. Also my text box is too small, but as you can see, it's not very user-friendly, but we can use this information that we get from the result. We can put in language for the different types of errors. But we could also do things like if there's nothing entered, we could say, maybe we'll make a function for sign up check. Void sign up check. And we can do things like when we click the button that says, you know, sign up, it should first do something like, is the first field filled out? Is the next field filled out? Are the other fields filled out? We can put in our own language to say, please enter a username. Please enter a email. Please enter a password. So we can fill out the validation and we can handle it how we like. We can make it really nice. But what we have is a functioning login. You know, if we put in a username and just, this is supposed to be an email address and a password, it will give an error and it will tell you, like, you know, this is not a valid email address. So we can start checking some of these things on our own through Unity. We can also use some of these errors to inform us of any issues that might come up, like if the user already exists or if the password and thing doesn't match. That is how you can set up a login and sign up for PlayFab. Again, you can make it as fancy as you like. You can use it for any type of game. And it can work on multiple different devices. And that's the thing that I think is the coolest, because if we build this for, you know, a downloadable game, an executable, a browser game, or if we have it on our mobiles, whether it's an app or wherever we access it from different devices, different platforms, we can still have the same account that we can play in. And that's something that's not easy to do. As you just saw, it took very little time to set it up and start using. So that's really cool. So hope you guys enjoyed that. I'm really having fun with this project. I'm having fun with PlayFab, and I hope it's useful for you guys as well. Thank you to Microsoft Azure for sponsoring our stream. It's been a lot of fun.